Bambili Africa. Everybody.
News Click में आपका स्वागत है। इस समय हैं हम न्यूयॉर्क और न्यू जर्सी में। दोनों ही जगहों पर तीन दिन की एक कॉन्फ्रेंस हुई, बहुत ही ऐतिहासिक कॉन्फ्रेंस, जहां पर 24 देशों के लोग आए और उन्होंने घोषणा की कि एक ग्लोबल प्लेटफॉर्म बनाया जाएगा जिसमें जन्म और काम के आधार पर जिस तरह का भेदभाव होता है उसके खिलाफ एक अंतर्राष्ट्रीय मुहिम छेड़ी जाएगी, ग्लोबल प्लेटफॉर्म ऑन डिसेंट एंड वर्क बेस्ड डिस्क्रिमिनेशन। इसकी घोषणा यहाँ पर हुई है। इसमें तमाम देशों से आए हुए जनप्रतिनिधियों ने, MP और पार्लियामेंटेरियंस ने शिरकत की और यहाँ पर संयुक्त राष्ट्र संघ से मांग की गई है कि वह एक स्पेशल फंड बनाए ताकि ये जो डिस्क्रिमिनेटेड कम्युनिटीज़ हैं इनके उत्थान के लिए और इनके सही पार्टिसिपेशन के लिए समय और धन दोनों खर्च किया जा सके। यहाँ पर हमने बात की जो जिप्सी या रोमा कहने वाले लोग हैं जिनका ओरिजिन पंजाब से है, हमने बात की सोमालिया से आए हुए लोग, हमने बात की छोटे छोटे देशों में जहाँ पर स्लेवरी का एक अभिशाप रहा है, गुलामी का अभिशाप वो लोग झेलते रहे हैं, उन लोगों से बात की जो भारत से आए हुए लोग हैं, जो दलित समुदाय से आए हुए लोग हैं, वो जो जिस तरह से लड़ रहे हैं, यहाँ पे जो डायस्पोरा है, दलित डायस्पोरा है, वह किस तरह से लड़ाई कर रहा है और ये तमाम लोग इस ऐतिहासिक क्षण में हाथ मिलाकर अपने अपने देशों के सरकारों से तो मांग कर ही रहे हैं, साथ ही एक ग्लोबल प्लेटफॉर्म भी बना रहे हैं, क्योंकि अब इस समुदाय का मानना है कि जब तक अंतर्राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर यह आवाज़ नहीं उठेगी तब तक जो उनकी इंसाफ की लड़ाई है वह अपनी मंजिल तक नहीं पहुंच पाएगी।
कम्युनिटी सिमिलरली डिस्क्रिमिनेटेड ग्लोबली, वी आर ब्रिंगिंग देम टुगेदर। व्हाई इन न्यूयॉर्क इज बिकॉज दिस इज, वी आर क्रिएटिंग सम काइंड ऑफ प्रेशर एट द UN लेवल एंड आवर इंटरवेंशंस विल बी एट द SDG टू ट्राई एंड सी इफ वी कैन गेट एन वी कैन हैव अ मोर इंक्लूसिव डेवलपमेंट। वी हैव पार्टिसिपेंट्स फ्रॉम अबाउट 21 कंट्रीज एंड अबाउट 10 पार्लियामेंटेरियंस हु आर पार्ट ऑफ दिस।
आई थिंक एवरीथिंग इज इंपॉर्टेंट इन दिस कांग्रेस। व्हाट इज really important for me is to gather people coming from different regions of the world to speak about an issue which is not on the mainstream since a very long time. Now I think people are very aware that to fight for dignity, human dignity, and fight for justice, we need to raise this issue because we have a lot of people who are out of dignity, Edward, in the situation of humiliation and poverty and situation of slavery. And I think it's a necessity for the 21st century to do something to arise.
I think the importance lies in the fact that we managed to unite so many communities that have been advocating for their own rights, separating and sometimes isolated from each other. And I see the power in coming together and uniting our forces, because I do believe that if we can form a critical mass, our voices can be heard louder and it will be more difficult to dismiss it or to choose to not to hear it. And so it's a pleasure to meet Quilombo, Roma, Dalit representatives and others, especially from the African continent, because I think Asians, Europeans, Africans, those in the Americas have been sometimes working regionally, but not necessarily recognizing the power in this global networking. So I do hope that this conference will make us realize the strength that we can have together and will also help us realize the challenges that we face together and lead us to common solutions and advocacy strategies that will enhance our situation and will help us achieving the dignity and the rights that we are aiming for.
As was said, also among Roma we are different and we try to find a way together. And I think that this should be like our main priority at this moment, to have the one voice and to know to don't let nobody behind. So among ourselves, but also to keep those institutions who gave us certain promises accountable, because nobody should be left behind. I'm coming from the EGO Network, which is the European Roma Grassroots Organization Network. I have the pleasure to be also one of the organizers.
Yes, we are oppressed. Yes, we are marginalized. Yes, we have all sorts of kind of problems. Yes, But we must realize that we are the protectors of our society. Mm. We need to understand that rather being strangers to each other because of our color, because of our status or caste, we need to be sisters also. So women need to embrace their womanhood and see ourselves as a player in the society rather than being apart. So discrimination can be eradicated by being ourselves out of the ladder of being discriminated.
If you want to know about your country, you were just mentioning that it was difficult to get married if the person is not from the same caste. You were giving your reference also. Can you share a little more to have an Indian connect?
I think it's a little different, but things are improved because education and urbanization. But it's still an issue in some conservative region where it's impossible for you to marry somebody who is not belonging to the same caste to you. And I think even in urban area, you can see this issue used by somebody to create situation and difficulties for people. I think that it's not a question of marriage. Under Gabu system is the system you find during a very long time referring to the, related to the caste system. And of course, in some countries, in the north, for example, of Senegal, the survival of some things relating to slavery also still going on. And of course, we need to fight to stop these things, because it is time to end this kind of situation.
So caste still exists in Senegal?
Yes, of course. We have two kinds of things on caste. We have a caste from work, descent of work, and you have caste relating to griot, the people who are, have a legacy of tradition, using their language to have relationship, communication, things like that. And they have a very privileged position in the society because they receive a lot of money from people. Because it is a society where people must want to be seen, to be in good. And this griot play an important role, for example, for that.
This platform is basically what is being claimed. It's the first of its kind at the international level, where all the discriminated communities, be it on the basis of birth or work, are coming together. So whether this will have some, their voices will be heard at the UN level, because the UN summit is also going on, how you see the chances and the possibilities?
I think that we have to partner and we have to find our allies in the UN system. It can be other member states who care about these issues that we care about, but it can also be mechanisms, existing mechanisms that are already there. We talked about treaty bodies, how people can use the treaty bodies, the committees like mine, to advocate for their rights. We talked about special rapporteurs who can be on our side when we need to voice something. And we also talked about mechanisms like the universal periodic review, where governments and states are reviewing other states. So I think what we need to do is to map the opportunities that already exist, where we can go, where we can have our entry points. I am here in my double hat. I'm an activist, I'm a Roma advocate, but I'm also an independent human rights expert at the United Nations. So what I hope is that I can give some very practical tips to the participants here, and we can think together about how to use the UN better to to enhance and advance the cause of our communities.
What's historic about it?
It is definitely historic because this is the first conference of this kind to bring so many different discriminated communities together. And I think that this has never happened before. This is the first thing. The second thing is that I think it's a very good collective of communities similarly discriminated, but also coming together with their elected representatives from their respective countries on devising a strategy on how to move forward to look at inclusion in different UN platforms.
Can you tell something about the declaration which is adopted?
So we've adopted a declaration that is demanding that any policy, both global, national, regional and global, has to take into account these discriminated communities. What are their needs? We need to have special mechanisms to address discrimination based on work and dissent in many of these countries where this kind of discrimination exists.
Thank you.